to Game 1 of the 2013 World Series between the American League champion New York White Sox and the National League champion Colorado Rockies. This is yours truly, John Camillo, as we get set for this best-of-seven series to determine who will become the world champion of Major League Baseball in the season 2013. It is a complete sold-out crowd here. Coors Field is the second time this franchise has been in the World Series. Take a look at the team info for this year. The Sox, you know, 135 wins, 27 losses. And, of course, the Rockies with 97 and 95 wins as well. A look at Cliff Lee, who's the starting pitcher, and Chichen, who will be on the mound for the Rockies. So you look at the two starting pitchers, and you look at the setup here. It is a sold-out crowd as both teams are getting introductions as we speak. Rockies take the field. They will be taking the field in the top of the first while the Sox will be batting. It's the Sox and the Rockies, Game 1 of the Fall Classic, the 2013 World Series. We'll get underway right after these messages, right here on WON 5 Sports.
Hey, I'm telling you, 1048 Churchill is an empty lot. Check it again, Sam.
Are you sitting down? Twins! Yeah, I just found out.
Maria, was I in the 405 at 515 or the 515 at 405?
Want to shoot some hoops? Then ask your mom.
Whatever you need it for, there's always a public phone nearby.
Max, I got a problem.
And America's calling card makes it even easier to call.
Now, you said green pepper, right? Red. Yeah, I meant red.
Phone in window.
At Manufacturers Hanover, we make the facts work for you. That's why you're coming to us for the facts on savings. Facts on credit needs. You're also calling our special fact phones, using our fact coupons and fact sheets, attending our free fact seminars. You're even getting the facts and cash from our MHT 24-hour banking centers. So keep coming to Manufacturers Hanover Trust, where our facts make your money worth more.
Look where the facts got us.
Welcome back to Coors Field, Game 1 of the 2013 World Series. Glad you could join us here on WON YouTube. Yours truly, John Camillo, bring you the best of seven of this World Championship Series to determine who's the champion of Major League Baseball this season. Powered by MLB 13, the show. And here comes the National League champion, Colorado Rockies, on under the field. We told you about both of these starters. Cliff Lee 0-2 so far in the postseason. Chichen with a good record as well, but Lee has yet to record a postseason victory. He has taken a loss twice. Here's the lineup for the Sox. There's no DH when the American League team is in the National League Park. Lori Cano, Hamilton, Don Gonzalez, Batista, McCann, Stanton, and the pitcher Lee will be batting. And they'll be facing Chichen, who's 1-2, and an ERA of 6.14, 4 games in the fifth, 22 innings pitched, 19 hits, 16 walks, and 17 strikeouts. I cannot pronounce this guy's name, so that's why I just call him Chichen. A full capacity crowd for Game 1 of his best of 7 2013 Fall Classic. And coming out to bat is Jet Lowry, hitting at 441 with 10 postseason home runs and 21 runs batted in. Chichen versus Lowry here at Coors Field. And the start of the 2013 Fall Classic is underway. First pitch lifted deep to left. Back at the outfielder. Still going back at the track, at the wall. It is gone. So long, farewell. The jet is loose. He did it time and time again in the season. He did it in the Division Series, the League Championship, and now he does it in the World Series. A leadoff homer for Jet Lowry. The jet is loose, and the Sox lead 1-0. Hey, Jet, this fight's for you. What a start. Holy cow, what a start. He got a pitch he can drive, and he drove it in the left field, and it is a home run, a leadoff homer for Lowry. His 11th of the postseason. Holy cow, what a start to this one. And a good one for the Sox. Here's Cano hitting at 393 with 6 homers and 11 runs batted in. So a good start to this World Series for New York with Lurie's leadoff home run in his 11th postseason home run. Connell drills it in the air, deep center field. Back goes Fowler, still going back on the warning track at the wall. The ball is gone! So long farewell! Back to back! Robinson Connell, don't you know? It's a bomb into the deepest part of ballpark. It's 2-0 New York. Hey, Robinson, this part's for you. Holy cow, what a start! Another home run for the Sox, and now Hamilton flies one deep to right. Her ball is gone. 3 home runs in a row. Sox lead it 3-0. Josh hammers one, and Hamilton is bunched for you. 3 consecutive first pitches have been drilled over the fence, and that one was a bomb. 3-0 White Sox. What a start. I don't think that's ever happened in World Series history. On 3 pitches, 3 home runs have been hit. Back to back, it is 3-0. Back to back to back home runs. This one was a long shot and a no-doubter. My goodness, what a start to this World Series for the New York White Sox. Here's Adam Dunn. By the way, Cano's home run is 7th. And for Hamilton, that is his 7th. So with 3-0 White Sox, done the batter, and this time he does not connect. First swing of the ball game, and a sarcastic cheer from the crowd here in Colorado. 3-0 White Sox. 3 home runs in a row, one by Lurie, one by Cano, and one by Hamilton. No balls, one strike on Dunn. Judson in a whole heap of trouble right now. Not a good start to game one. That popped up in the air, and that is finally going to be the very first out of the ball game as Todd Helton, in his last year in his career, makes the catch. Hutchins has to be breathing a sigh of relief. Here's Agon, hitting a 392 with 4 homers and 7 runs batted in. Three to nothing, 2-1 out here in the top of the first inning for New York. That one's fouled to the left side, strike one. Oh and one on Gonzalez. And he'll hit one to first. Good grab by Helton. He'll make the tag at first. Quickly two gone. After 3 home runs in a row, 2 outs in a row. It's hard to believe this is the 20th season for Colorado baseball. As we look at Batista, 7 home runs, 16 runs batted in. Average at 309. They started in the 1993 season, and their first opening game opponent was the New York Mets. They got a walk-off home run. That was a Sunday night game that was over on ESPN. During that time, there's a hard shot, what a grab by the third baseman to throw on his knees. Helton makes the play. We'll see the Rockies story in a moment, but after one half, 3-0 Sox, Rockies coming back. game one of the World Series here from Denver, Colorado. And leading off is Eric Young Jr., hitting at 250 with no homers and two runs batted in. He's the right fielder and a right-handed batter. The pitch by Lee is too high, 1-0. During his postseason run, location has been the main issue for Cliff Lee. There's no question about it. He has pitched more than two postseason games, but he has gotten a no decision out of some of his starts, but he has taken two losses in the postseason. I know he does not want to have a loss in this series. It's a big one to determine who will be champion of baseball. Ground ball, base hit in the right center. Good start for the Rockies. And at first, that's Eric Young Jr. with the first hit of the ballgame for Colorado. I don't think that's what McCann wanted from the pitch from Lee. And now bring up Dexter Fowler hitting at 310 with one homer and seven runs batted in. 3-0 Sox. Colorado with a man at first. Strike taken on the two-seamer on one. Three to nothing Sox. We're in the bottom of the first. What a start for the Sox offense. Three consecutive homers in a row on three pitches in a row. There's a pop-up in the foul ground. Adam Dunn's got a beat on this. Eric Young won't move anywhere as that's caught for out number one. So Dexter Fowler retired. And the batter will be Carlos Gonzalez, hitting a 289 so far in the postseason. Three homers and eight runs batted in. Big left-handed power. Young man who will get prepared to take over the duties as being the face of this Colorado franchise. There's a rip to right. And Batista makes the catch. Young will go back to first. And there's two gone. And with the retirement of Todd Helton, who's been the face of this franchise, after being drafted, he's prepared for the challenge. A look at how both of these teams got here. Colorado, of course, beat the Giants, Cincinnati. And you know the Sox beat Texas and the Blue Jays. And the Blue Jays series and Texas series was very hard. This course on the rookie, four homers, 14 runs batted in. Hitting at an average of 359 so far in the postseason. Man's at first, two out, 3-0 New York. Here's the pitch to Troy. There's a strike, a high one. And the count is 2-0. That pit nipped the high corner of that strike zone. No balls, one strike. I was saying this before I went to the break. That is the 20th season of Rockies baseball. And the first time these guys took the field in Colorado was back in 93. And there's a base hit in the right field. And the Shed hit the game-winning home run against the Mets. It was a Sunday night game. It was on ESPN. And back then, they were playing over in Mile High Stadium, and they just moved to this ballpark a couple of years ago. I believe it was 98 or 99. I believe it was 98. They moved into this ballpark, and this is called a home run barn because the humidor, which they had to install, prevents more baseball from going into the seats. But when there was no humidor, the cold air just took the ball out. You look at Rosario, and every day these baseballs flew deeper than any place I ever seen. Well, they have a humidor trying to prevent that from happening, but unfortunately, in the Rockies side, it is a rip and foul. They haven't had a winning season until now. Last time they had a winning season, you got to date back to 2011 and took on the Red Sox, and they lost to the Red Sox in the World Series. That ball's taken outside, 1-1 on Rosario. He's the potential tying run. Two consecutive two base hits in this inning for the Rockies, surrendered by Cliff Lee. Has a 3-0 lead a nurse. The 1-1, the Rosario rips to left field and deep. Back goes Hamilton, but he's got a beat on him. Now take care of the Rockies. Two hits, two men are stranded. We have played one here in Denver. 3-0 Sox. Brian McCann leads off. Seven homers, 11 runs batted in, hitting at an average .455 so far this postseason. Start of the second, 3-0 White Sox here in game one of the World Series. And Chin Chin back on the mound. Fouled away, strike one on McCann. Giancarlo Stanton is on deck, followed by Cliff Lee, which is the pitcher spot. There is no DH International League ballpark. Of course, a lot of fans and a lot of folks in baseball would like that, but the National League owners will not go for it. And it's a disadvantage for the American League teams, especially in this kind of a series, the World Series. If you go to American League ballpark, yeah, you have the option of putting an extra power back. If you go to National League, that is not the case. Right now, nothing at two on McCann. And got him swinging strike three. Now make it official by throwing the first. And it is in time. One gone to begin the second inning. Giancarlo Stanton, who had an ALCS to remember, stands in with seven homers, a ton of runs batted in. And his average over 300, undoubtedly so. There's a pitch he should not have swung at, strike one. Last year with the Marlins, Giancarlo Stanton had the Rockies number. He hit eight home runs in his ballpark in one series. And it was a four-game series. And he hit two in each of them. Well, actually, he had three and two of them, and two and one. Well, it was a three-game series. He had three in two games. He had three in one game, three in the second game, and two in the final game. That was a three-game series, not a four-game series. That was last year when he was with the Marlins. So the Rockies are going to try to be careful with Stanton here. And here's the 1-1 delivery. That's a ground ball, fair one down the left field line. It kicks right near the outfielder. Stanton has good wheels on his way to second. The throw is not into... Oh, they stays out! Holy cow, I thought he was in there. The second base umpire says he was out, and I don't know if that's the case. And Stanton cannot be happy. So is not the manager. I thought he was safe. So now it's Cook Lee. Wow, that is a... questionable call, to say the least. Lee grounded to second, and now take care of an inning. Could be a controversial one. Apparently, Stanton was tagged out. Now the second, three on the Sox in game one of the World Series. Jordan Petzschel will step in. One homer, seven runs batted, and averaging at 273 as we begin the bottom of the second, and a fair ball down the right field line. That ball will kick all the way to the wall. It's a bad bounce for Batista. Runner easily goes to second as a stand-up double. No controversy on that hit, but I'll tell you what, from the naked eye, seeing Stanton go for two, I thought that he was at second base. The tag came late, apparently. We kept on looking at the replays. And he was safe at second. That was a blown call by the second base umpire. Now Patrick, now Rutledge will come in the bat for the Rockies. And here's a disturbing creature that's just bouncing and bouncing. And that looks to be the rhinoceros. That's the mascot of the Rockies. There's a ground ball to second. I'll move the runner up. The throw to first is in time. One gone. Third base. Look at the ground ball again. There you saw the runner easily moving to third. And there's Scott Helton. He got 114, one home run, three runs batted in the postseason. His last year in the postseason before he retires. He says that this will be his last year of his career, a tremendous career. Could be a Hall of Fame career, of course. The writers have to determine was his numbers because of the situation of the ballpark, and that's what every writer is probably going to say, as that ball is taken outside, 1-1. The infield is in to try to get the force out at home. The outfield is normal as well. There is some speed, a little bit, I wouldn't say that much, at third base. Hilton grounds it, and they're going to throw home, and it's not going to work. It's 3-1, and that could be a throwing error on Gonzalez. The ball was slowly hit. And here's the pitcher, Chin Chin, who will probably bump for a base hit if he wants to. They'll roll out a base hit. Now he is going to show bunt here, and he bunts it, and that's a good one, too. And they're going to throw to second and not get anybody. Another close play at second. And now it's up to Eric Young Jr. Nobody was covering first, and Dunn had no choice but to throw to second and try to get the out. They rolled out a base hit. And Eric Young, ball almost got past the catcher McCann. Good block by Bryant. 1-0 to Eric. He went too far. Strike number one. 1-1. Three to one Sox. We are in the bottom of the second, and the Rockies are threatening. By the way, the tying runs on base. And a run has scored for Colorado. 1-2 by Lee is outside. 2-2. The 2-2 to Young is fouled away again. Again, the 2-2 is rounded. Base hit in the right field. They're going to try to wave that runner. They will not. And the base is loaded. Four Colorado players. And the batter will be Dexter Fowler, 0-1. The tying run now is at second base. The go-ahead run is at first. There is some speed on the base pass. Fowler, fair down the left field line. And they're going to try to wave that tying run. They will not. It's 3-2, New York. Good throw by Hamilton to keep the pitcher, Chin-Chin, from going home. He made a wide turn at third, but to no avail. It's 3-2, the tying run now 90 feet away, and it's Carlos Gonzalez. And the postseason struggles for Cliff Lee continue. One out delivery to Gonzalez is there for a strike. There's still one out. The infield is in for potential double play. Three to two, New York. They lead Colorado by one run. The tying run now 90 feet away. And here's a short ground ball. They're only going to get one. They're going to have to surrender the tying run. They don't get nobody. Cano held onto the ball too much, and the game is tied at three. That's going to be an error, most likely, on Robinson Cano. That was an accidental swing. Don't know what happened there. Cano held onto the ball too much. I don't think he would have gotten him anyway. The ball was hit too slowly. We'll see how the market. Now it's Troy Tulowitzki. One out. The game is tied at three, and the bases are still loaded. Going to be a big hit, and rightfully so. There's a strike. Troy does not agree, and the count is 0-1. A rough inning for Cliff Lee right now. 3-3 is the score. Trying to put your finger on why Lee is struggling in the postseason. You just can't figure out why. And a pop-up is a big out to get. Gonzalez makes the catch. He'll throw home to keep that runner right where he is. There's two outs. So Troy's struggle continues. And the batter is now Rosario. 0-1, a flyout back in the first inning. Two outs, bases loaded. Tie game. Ground ball to second. Cano's got it. And this inning's over. It was 3-0. The sitting down is game tied at three at the end of two in game one of the four classes. Started third, and Jet Lloyd began the ball game with a bang. A home run to left field. It was set up a three-run rally for the Sox, three home runs in a row. And now here in the third, the game is tied at three. Lloyd with another drive in the left field. Back is the left fielder at the water. Ball is gone. So long, Phil. Punch chin is loose. 4-3 Sox. Hey, Lloyd is bud for you. Man, oh man, is he in a zone. In his first season as a New York Sox, he not only has had a tremendous season, a tremendous postseason, but he is coming out and turning out to have a tremendous World Series, and we're already in game, only in game one, with a possible six games to go. My goodness, what a start to this World Series for Jet Lawrie, his second of the World Series, here's Robinson Cano. My oh my, what a season, what a postseason. For Jet Lawrie. Cano swings and misses strike one on the slider. Second time that Lawrie has seen a pitch and has driven it to left field. You don't see that every day. 0-1 to Cano. Got a piece of that one, 0-2, almost fell. Lost his balance. Trying to keep that swing in balance. It'll be an 0-2 to Cano, and it's a hot shot to short. One gone here in the third inning. It's Josh Hamilton. He's one for one tonight with a solo shot. I mean, he hit a bomb into the bullpen in right field off the back wall of the bullpen. And he stands in with one out and a run in thanks to Lawrie's leadoff homer here in the third. Now he hammers one up the middle. It's a base hit in the right center. His second hit of the ballgame. And now bring up the big man, Adam Dunn. Dunn 0 for 1 popped up in foul ground. And the first base side, Elton put him away with the catch. He has turned into some big player through the last two games of the ALCS with some big home runs, big hits. We'd like to carry that momentum into this series. And there's a high fly in the left center field, right center, and it's by the second baseman. Runner at the hold up, but everybody's safe. I'll tell you, Hamilton had to beware that ball wasn't going to be caught. That's why he held up between first and second. And the ball just got over the second baseman's head. That is a blooping single for Dunn. It's first and second, one out. And the dangerous Jose Bautista to make it Adrian Gonzalez, followed by Jose Bautista. He's at the plate right now. First and second, one out. Adrian, a ground ball, this could be two. This is going to be a tough one to turn. They will not get it. They get only one out of it. Runners at the corners with two outs now, and the dangerous Jose Bautista is now coming to the plate, who grounded out back in the first. Bautista tried to go deep into the Colorado Rocky Mountains with that swing on one. Two outs, two on, a run in thanks to Lawrie's leadoff home run here in the third. The Sox, of course, always looking for more. There's a shot but foul down the left side and into the stands. Sox looking to cash in on this inning. First and third right now. Two outs. And an 0-2 count on Bautista. And the pitch on the way is in the air. Left center field and deep. Back goes Fowler. Back to the track. Back at the wall. And it's gone. So long, so well. Joey goes batty. A 3-1 homer and a Sox lead at 7-3. Hey, Jose, this bite for you. Sox need some runs, and that is exactly what they got. It was hard to come by in the ALCS until game six. And it seems like they're coming up with big hit after big hit when they need it, and that is a big one. It is now 7-3 White Sox here in the third in game number one of the World Series. That ball took a long time to come down. We told you this Colorado air, very different because of the high climate. And here is McCann who struck out back in the second. For Batista, that's a big three-run home run. And it comes at a big time. McCann swings and misses strike one. 7-3 New York White Sox on top of the Colorado Rockies here in game one of the World Series. Best of seven to determine who will become the world champion of baseball for the 2013 campaign. Sox have won three titles in a row. And they're aiming for their fourth one as McCann gets hit on a pitch way inside. And that's just frustration on Chichin. Don't know if that's intent or not. And here's Giancarlo Stanton, one for one. And I'll tell you what, this pitcher for the Rockies, not long. And we're having some discussions between Stanton and the catcher of the Rocky. You saw the umpire come between both those players. So I wonder, what's the deal there? Stanton swings and misses strike one. You see the manager, he looks like he's half asleep. Not a good time for you to fall asleep when your team is down 7-3 in a championship game, the best of seven championship series. You have to stay awake. Two outs, one on. Four runs in for the Sox. Stanton just got a piece of that one, 0-2. Should have not gone for it, but he did. On Stanton, man's at first. That man is McCann, who was hit by a pitch. Stanton strikes out. That'll take care of the Sox. But not before two home runs. The big one, a three-run shot off of Jose Bautista. 7-3, Sox lead near the third. Jordan Petro, who doubled back in the second, leads off here in the bottom of the third. 7-3 Sox here in game one of the World Series. Yours truly, Josh Rios. Glad you could join us here on WON UPN 5 New York. And it's going to be a base hit in the right. Bautista with a tremendous strong throws in the second. Another hit for Petro. And he'll lead off with a single. And now bring up Josh Rutledge. The pitch on the way to Josh is there for a strike, nip the high corner. Josh does not agree with the call on one.
Thank you for bringing the mail, Mom.
The 0-1 on the way. Ooh, that looks like he got a piece of that bat, hurt some wood, but it's fouled into the glove, and it's a 0-2 count. To the Rutledge. He struck him out looking. That is the first strikeout of the ball game for Cliff Lee and the Sox, and there is a big out right there. One gone. So, in one gone and a man at first, it's not helped to result for one with a ground down and an RBI driven in. Big guy to get, and he was lunging for that sweeping curveball, 0-1 on Todd Helton. You see Carlos Gonzalez in the backdrop, he is on deck. The 0-1 to Helton, there's a strike that nips the inside corner. Todd looking at the umpire, in a confused way, does not agree with the call, and the count is now 0-2 on Helton. Lee with a 4-run lead to work with. The Sox offense is giving him a lot to work with right now as Helton throws it to left field. Can of corn for Josh Hamilton. He'll make the catch, and the runner goes back to first. That ball nearly, that actually missed the cutoff man, but Dunn was there to back it up. Two gone. And the batter is the pitcher, Chunchin, who is 0-for-1 today. He scored the tying run, grounded out as well. And the first two out. Try tagging 0-1 on the pitcher. So Lee got that ball. He looked kind of surprised that that call was called a strike. It looked to be a little bit low outside. By the way, 0-2. Nothing in two on Chinchin. And the 0-2 is a drive down the left field line. It's going to stay fair. Doing that stuff to do with that ball. Now it's tied aside. One hit, a man is stranded. We have played three. Third game of the World Series. 7-3. Sox the clock. Cliff Lee, the batter. He's 0-for-1 and grounded out to second, back in the second inning. As we reach the top of the fourth inning, 7-3 New York. Lee with a pop-up. Down the left field line. It's going to curve foul, but it's going to come into the glove of the third baseman. There's quickly one gone. Here's the man of the hour, Jed Lowry, with two consecutive home runs on two pitches. And both to left field, the home runs. This one he'll drive right to the shortstop, so Lowry will be retired for the bit. Holy cow, he was not! Apparently he saved it first. I thought he was out. A good play and throw by Troy Tulowitzki. We got to take a look if he was saved or out. Good play by Troy here. The transfer was good. Bang, bang. That's a tough call to make. He could go either way, out or safe. I can't judge that call. I just can't. So Lowry's on for the third time, this time with an infield single, apparently. And Robinson Cano's the batter. They're ruled out of base and undoubtedly so. It had to be Lowry's speed that made him be safe at first. Cano swings and misses 0-1. Some close calls in his game. The tag out to Stanton's hand apparently in the double. And this one just now at first. Speaking of first, man's at first with one gone. The 0-1 to Cano. He got a piece of it right up the middle. Diving stuff by Troy. Will not get anybody. A tremendous effort by Troy Tulowitzki. The problem was he couldn't handle it. First and second, one out for the Sox. They're at it again. And the manager has seen enough. We will keep it here. During the World Series, we will not break the commercial break, but Chinchin is out the game. A tough night for him. And a right-hander, Miguel Batista, will be pitching for the Rockies. And he only has 7.50. He's been in four games so far, a total of six innings. And here's Josh Hamilton, who's 2-for-2 with a home run and a single. And they'll rule that a base hit, and undoubtedly so. Oh, he was aiming for the upper tank on that one, 0-2. Not a good swing on a very bad pitch. No balls, one strike on Hamilton. And the pitch by Batista. Josh hits one deep to left field. And the left fielder cannot get it. Neither can a shortstop. They'll throw the second. They'll get the out. And there was nothing that Cano could do because That ball could have been caught. So two outs in the inning despite a base hit. The bases could have been loaded. But again, Cano had to hold up it between first and second. Not his fault at all. That's just the game of baseball, unfortunately. And now bring him Adam Dunn. Adam 1-for-2 with that same type of a bloop single. You hate to see those kind of plays as that ball's taken outside. You just hate it because the runner is powerless because he's trying to determine that ball's going to be caught or not. It was not, but nothing that Cano could do. He was way out at first. And tagged at second. So instead of being the bases loaded, one out, it's runners at the corners and two outs for Adam Dunn, who hits one a mile. Deep to right field. Fowler can't get to it. It is off the wall. One run will score. It's 8-3 New York. Adam gets it done with an RBI double. And here's Agon, who's 0-for-2. A 5-run lead for the Sox here in the top of the fourth. Second and third occupied. And two outs. Adrian, what was he swinging at? What was he swinging at? I have no idea. Neither is he. 0-1. No balls, one strike. And the pitch on the way. And Adrian, I don't know what he's swinging at. And now he's falling behind. 0-2. He is actually 0-for-2 as well. Sox with 11 hits, Rockies with 7, and I know, and I'll say this again, even though it's 8-3, the Sox are looking for more. This is a team that does not like to leave runners on base. Outside to it, 1-2. It'll be a 1-2 to Gonzalez. And the pitch by Batista. That's ripped deep to right field. Way back it goes. And it is gone. So long, farewell. Ethan goes bonkers. A 3-run homer. And he's becoming a locker in Denver. 11-3 Sox. Hey, Adrian, this buzz for you. That was a line drive poker. We told you since game 6 of the ALCS, this team has been driving in runs more often than not. And it has carried them into this game. A 3-run homer for Adrian Gonzalez. A line drive shot. And the Sox have blown the door on this one, 11-3. My, oh my. And again, the Sox come through when they need it. Here's a man that came through last inning. He's 1-for-2. That's Batista with a 3-run homer. Well, Gonzalez is a 3-run homer, and it's 11-3 Sox against Colorado here in the top of the fourth inning. Jose Batista went too far, strike one. Oh, one delivery, that's too high. Count is 1-1. 11-3 New York White Sox lead the Colorado Rockies here in game one of the World Series. We are in the top of the fourth inning. And 1-1 is the count on Jose Batista, no relation to Miguel Batista, who he's facing on the mound as we speak. The 1-1. That's clubbed to left field and deep. And that's going to be a base hit that'll hit off the 390 side. Batista's very slow when it comes to running, but he's in there with a double. Second here in the ball game for Batista, and the route continues to go on here in Colorado. That's what you call a gapper. And that's exactly what it was. And now the batter is Brian McCann, who was hit by a pitch his last time up, and now is back in the third inning. 11-3 Sox, man, to second with two outs. And the pitch to McCann. That ball bounces. And Batista's smart to go back to second, which he does. And he's there safely. One oh. McCann hits one into the night, deep in the right, way, way out of here. So long, farewell in the second tier. McCann ends one, and it is now 13-3. Hey, Brian, this bite's for you. And the fans here in the Rocky Mountains giving that Rockies a whole lot of boo. That ball was destroyed, and a no-doubter for Brian McCann. 13-3 New York. The onslaught continues here in game one of the World Series. An awful performance by the Rockies pitching staff, no question about it. Boy, that ball was drilled deep to right. Here's Giancarlo Stanton. 441 feet from McCann. Again, the Sox do not leave a runner on base. That ball is clearly outside. And things have been, well, I'll tell you what, the Rockies have made matters worse putting Miguel Batista into this game. And he has done nothing but surrender runs and some long home runs. And that one by McCann was long. And Gonzalez's shot was smoked. 1-0 to Stanton, and he gets a piece of it, 1-1. It'll be a 1-1 to Stanton. Way outside, and Stanton giving Batista a look. The Sox have hit 7 home runs so far tonight. And folks, we are only in the top of the fourth inning. 2-1 is the count. And when I say the top of the fourth, that means we have a lot of ball game to go. That's drilled to left and deep. And that ball is gone. Oh my goodness. That ball left the ballpark in a hurry. A line drive bomb. A Stanton smash. Back-to-back on the Sox, it is now 14-3. Hey, Giancarlo's, this bite for you. Throw in the surrendering towels already. The Sox have put up 11. We'll make it 14 runs and have an 11-run lead. My goodness, and I tell you, that was a rip. He does it to the Rockies again. And here's Cliff Lee, who's 0-for-2. So the Rockies may want to breathe a sigh of relief as Stanton hits his 8th home run of the postseason. Lee has hit a home run. You might remember the series against the Washington Nationals. 2 nights in a row. The Sox pitchers hit a home run. Batista hit 2 home runs. And Cliff Lee hit 1 the next night. Right now, he can rest easy. Well, he can't rest easy. He has to go on the mound. But right now, he has an 11-run cushion to work with. And he's going to be out as the play is made. And this nightmare inning for Colorado comes to a close. The Sox put up a ton. Bill the fourth, 14-3 Sox lead. Eric Young Jr., who's 2-for-2 here tonight, leads off here in the top of the fourth. 14-3 Sox lead here in game one of the World Series. There's a strike. And the count is nothing and one. Well, Lee may get his first postseason win. We don't want to jinx it. Still got a lot of ball game to go here in game one. And there's a base hit in the right field. And Batista lets that ball pass. And that's a bad job by Jose Batista. And Eric Young has a tremendous wheel right behind him. And he has himself a triple. Was shooting just an old single. Turns out to be a triple. I don't know if it was a controller glitch or something. But he's got third and missed just the foul. Fouled away, strike one. The 0-1 is ripped to left. Now Hamilton has a tremendous arm. Makes the catch. Runner will come around to score it. The throw is way offline. It is now 14-4 in New York. Well, they get the out. You knew they were going to trade the run for the out. It was still a big lead. But, listen, you trade a run for an out, that's better than nothing. Here's Collison's out. 1-for-2 here tonight. Takes a cutter in there for a strike, 0-1. Game 2 tomorrow night. And we'll have the game at 8 o'clock right here on UPN 5, so you don't want to miss it. Game 2 here from Coors Field to determine who leads this series. Right now, Sox have a lead. It is now 14-4. I'd like to keep it that way and probably add more. He's still got a lot of ball game to go to do that. The center field, Tanner Kornquist, he didn't have to move that much. Two outs. Troy Tulowitzki, the batter, 1-for-2 with a single back in the first inning. Lee center of the belt with two outs here. Takes the strike to count as 0-1. 14-4, New York leads the Colorado Rockies here in game one of the World Series. Best of seven. First two games here in Colorado, and the next couple at the stadium, and then the last two in Colorado. And a ground ball to Lowry. Good play. This inning comes to a close. One run on one hit. And at the end of four, it's 14-4 Sox lead. Jed Lowry, who's had a tremendous night so far, leads off here in the fifth inning, a perfect 3-for-3 with two home runs and one infield single. Batista still on the mound. Lopez is warming in the bullpen for the Rockies, just in case more damage is done. Fouled away, strike one on Lowry. The ball's one strike. And the pitch.
No ball, two strikes.
Strike two is the count. 0-2. Batista we're ahead of Lowry 0-2, trying to retire him for the very first time. And he does. So Lowry's 3-for-3 day is over. He's now 3-for-4. And there's one gone. Sox with 14 runs, 15 hits, no errors. The Rockies, 4 runs, 8 hits, and no errors at all. And Robinson Cano, the batter, 2-for-4 with a home run and a single. One out and nobody on. That's gone. Deep to right. That's headed for the second deck. So long, farewell. Second home run of the night for Cano. It's 15-4 New York. Hey, Cano, this bud for you. That is the second time we've seen a baseball land in the second deck in right. And another no-doubter. As soon as it left the bat, you knew it was gone. He got all of that one, and it's back to an 11-run lead. That is, I believe, the ninth home run of the game for the Sox. This one was no cheapie. When he hits him, they can go a long way. It looks like he's not even trying, but when he hits him a long way. Here's Josh Hamilton. 2-for-3. That ball measured at 448 feet. That's a little bit further than Brian McCann's home run. Got a piece of it. Strike one on Hamilton. The 1-through-3 batters have all had home runs. Lori with two, Cano with two, and Hamilton with only one. Right back to the mound, not a very good swing, and there's out number two. Adam Dunn with a good night tonight. He has a double and a single here. He's also popped up, and that was back in the first inning. Fifth inning, two outs, 15-4 is the score. And he's going to be retired. So will the Sox. One hit, one run off the bat of Robinson Cano. We're halfway through here in Colorado. 15-4, Sox lead here in game one of the World Series. Quinlan Rosario out. 15-4 is the score in favor of the New York White Sox. Yours truly, Jonathan Rios. What has turned into an offensive explosion for the White Sox. And trying to keep it that way as Lee ahead of the count 0-1. Halfway through this ball game, and you can tell the excitement for Colorado. They want to get out of this game as much as they can and try to get right back at these boys tomorrow. Base hit in the left field and Rosario is on for the first time today. A single to lead off the fifth. Jordan Petro will step in. He's 2-for-2 here tonight with a double and a single. And here's the Colorado mascot, the Rhino, trying to get his fan base up and at it, trying to root right behind their team despite being down by 11. High fly ball, right field, and Batista with a tremendous catch. One gone. That could have scored a run if it would have went over his head. But makes a tremendous running catch for the first out of the inning. Here's a look at it one more time. And Batista had to go a long way to get to that ball. Very close to being problem. So the batter now is Josh Rutledge, who's 0-for-2 here tonight, struck out and grounded out. One out pitch is a strike, 0-1. To Josh. Here's a strike going to 15-4 Sox. Fifth inning of game one of the World Series. There's been a home run explosion for the White Sox. They've hit about 9 home runs so far in this game tonight. That's got to be a World Series record, I think. Into deep right field. That could be issued for Batista. And again, right on the warning track, makes a tremendous catch. Runner goes back to first base. Well, that is the second consecutive time we've seen Jose go a long way and make another tremendous catch. We've got to look at this again. Good swing, got a lot of it. But White Batista here, tracking it, and finally gets a hold of it and makes the catch. Another good catch for Batista. Here's Todd Elkins. Tough night for Todd. 0-for-2, grounded out and flied out here tonight. That's a base hit in the left field. That's his first hit of the ball game. First and second, two out. And a new pitch hitter for the pitcher, and that's Chris Nelson. 125 average, no homers, and no runs batted in. Two outs, two on. And a base hit in the right field. They're going to wave that runner home. Here comes the throw. They got him by a mile. Inning over. The third base runner ran through the stop sign and then crossed him. End of five, 15-4 Sox lead.
Supergirl has the ability to save millions upon millions of lives with her great superpowers. Americans have the ability to save thousands of lives, one at a time.
16,000 people die each year in car crashes that don't have to. Safety belts could save their lives. Safety belts could also prevent thousands from being horribly disfigured or crippled for life. So buckle up. Your life is in your hands.
Some banks give you hundreds of locations where you can get cash. Citibank gives you hundreds of locations where you can get banking. Not just cash, real banking. Make deposits and loan payments. Transfer money between accounts. Even pay Citibank Visa and MasterCard bills. 55 different transactions at hundreds of locations, 24 hours a day. Where you live, where you work, or both. Citibank. When, where, and how to succeed.
Hello, this is Universal City Studios, where we're filming Dragnet. I'd like to take just a minute to talk to those of you who will soon be 65 about signing up for your Medicare benefits under Social Security. Now, it's very important that you go into your Social Security office 2 or 3 months before your 65th birthday, regardless of whether you plan to retire or whether you want to continue working for a while. If you wait until you're already 65 to apply for Medicare, you will have lost some of the protection provided by this health insurance. The time to sign up is before you're 65, not after. Now, if you have a question about Medicare or about any of the other Social Security benefits, write, phone, or visit the Social Security office in your community. The people there will be glad to help you.
Wilton Lopez will come in to pitch for the Rockies with his team down by 11. And here comes Adrian Gonzalez, and back in the fourth inning, he had a smoker, line drive, three-run homer that reached the seats quickly. It is an 11-run ball game as we begin the top of the sixth, and the Sox offense looking for some more to tack on here, and that swung on a miss on one. O1 pitch to Adrian, and not even close, 0-2. No balls, two strikes on Gonzalez. And that's hit a long way. The ship was on. This one hit high in the right center. The Fowler is there, and will make the catch for out number one. So Gonzalez is retired. That'll bring up Jose Bautista, who in the third inning came up with a big hit, a three-run homer in the left field. And that may prove to be the game winner if the Sox maintain and hold on to this lead. A big three-run home run after having a 4-3 lead, only hanging on to a one-run lead and then extending it to a four-run lead. And Sox have not looked back ever since, swinging a miss, strike one on Bautista. O-1 on the way. Another swing and a miss, 0-2. These pitches look hittable, but Lopez is just throwing them right by him. Oh, 2 to Jose. Got him. Couldn't hold up there. Two consecutive strikeouts for Lopez. Two gone here in the sixth. Here's McCann with a bomb back in the fourth inning in the second deck, the second tier of this stadium. Lopez with two outs under his belt. And maybe aiming for his third on one. He is throwing those sinkers right by these batters. See McCann talking to himself. Lopez ahead of McCann, nothing in one. The pitch by Lopez. That is on the ground, and that's a base hit. The ship was on, but it didn't work that time. Is on with his second hit of the ball game, and that'll bring up Giancarlo Stanton, who's 2-3. action in the Sox bullpen. And Stanton, who hit a home run his last time up, fouls it back, strike one. 0-1 to Stanton is ripped deep to right field. The right fielder is right there. I'll take care of the Sox. One hit, and he's stranded. We have played 5.5 here at Coors Field. 15-4, Sox lead the Rockies. The batter, 3-for-3 here tonight with a triple and two singles. He with an 11-run lead to work with here in the sixth inning. Could be his final inning of work. Ground ball to short. Roy will take care of it. One gone. Hit that ball right on the button, but to no avail. So the batter's best to follow. 1-for-2 with a single back in the second inning. And a ground ball to Dunn. He'll take care of it quickly. Two gone in the sixth. Here's Carlos Gonzalez, 1-for-3 with a single. His only hit of the ballgame is that single. And another single, Batista with the play, as Gonzalez is on for the second time tonight. Troy Kalawiski now the batter, 1-for-3 with a single back in the first inning. Two outs, one on. That's drilled in the deep left center. Stanton is there. This inning is over. One in, a man is stranded. We have played six here in the Rocky Mountains. 14-4, Sox leading game one of the World Series.
I am currently in possession of four grenades filled with advanced nuclear technology. You have 2 minutes to get here, or kaboom.
This looks like a job for Supergirl. I don't know who you are, what you're trying to do, but it won't happen on my watch.
I'm through playing these childish games! Where are the grenades?
I wouldn't have thought of it.
You think you're gonna get away with this?
The job will be done right now. Supergirl is finished. All that's left is to set off the grenades. Goodbye, sir.
Back here in Denver, a look at the game summary. 15-17-0 for the Sox, 4-12-0 for the Rockies. Jared Loy with a tremendous night. 3-for-4, 2 home runs, 2 RBIs, 3 runs total, a total of 3 hits. Eric Young, 3-for-4, and Cliff Lee. And I don't think they're going to bat for him. No, they are not going to bat for him. He will be pitching the 7th inning, apparently. And not a moment too soon. That's drilled deep to right field, and it is over the head of Eric Young. He better be careful, he don't want to be out. But how about Cliff Lee with a double in the World Series? So much for pitch hitting for him. He's a good hitter, no question about it. And here's Jet Laurie, who's had 2 home runs, a total of 3 hits. He's 3-for-4, heading to this at bat. Almost hit him too. One and all on Laurie. With a man at second, nobody out. That's up the middle, right to the second base, and the throw is too high. And that's probably going to have a run scoring it well. 16-4 is the score. That is definitely an error on the second baseman, who is not Derek Jeter. That is a bad play by the second baseman. Are you sure this team belongs in the World Series? My goodness, that ball was thrown into the Rockies dugout. Oh, Laurie and Lee get the extra base. It is now 16-4 on the run scoring error. That's an E4 on the second baseman. Now here's Cano, who has gone deep twice. Swings and misses there on one. Oh, one. Up the middle, diving stop by Troy Tulowitzki on his knees, can't get the out. That could be an error on the first baseman. A mess here in Coors Field. A tremendous play by Troy, but the throw a little bit offline that Hilton just could not scoop it up. It has been tough to watch, no question. Well, part of that three home runs in a row inning, making Josh Hamilton one of those guys that hit the three home runs in a row, as you look at the highlight from that. And that'll be an E6 on the play that was just made, that was not made. Swinging a miss on one on Hamilton. The 0-1 to Hamilton, that's not even close, 0-2. First and third occupied, nobody out, 0-2 on Hamilton. Adam Dunn is on deck and Hamilton strikes out. First out of the seventh. Adam Dunn with a good night tonight, a double and a single. He is 2-for-4 and has an RBI opportunity waiting in the wings. First and third, one gone, 16-4 is the score. This could go in anywhere. That is deep to right and it's gone. Oh my, did he smoke so long, farewell. Adam gets it done with a three-run homer. The 10th homer in this game for the White Sox. It is 19-4. Hey, Adam, this part for you. Into the second deck and right. And somehow when it left the bat, I knew it was gone. Oh my goodness. I don't know how. I do not have telepathy, but I tell you, he really crushed that one. I think the sound of the bat, as soon as that ball bounced off his bat, I knew it was going someplace, and he knew it too. And so did everybody in Coors Field. Look where this lands. Into the second deck. That is the third time tonight that a Sox player has hit a bomb into the second deck and right. And we have a new pitcher, Matt Burlesy. Velocity. I don't know how to say his name. Another three-run home run for the Sox. And he's off the bat of Dunn as Gonzalez grounds it foul. One out here in the seventh. As I keep saying to you folks, a lot of baseball to go. And for the Rockies, that's bad news. 0-2. Owen 2 is the count, 19-4 is the score in favor of the Sox here in game one of the World Series. And the Sox, the way they're going, look like they're going to take a 1-0 series lead. Outside, good eye by Gonzalez. 1-2. Disappointing for the Rocky fans. The performance their team has put out on the field as Gonzalez strikes out. It'll be official. It'll be tagged out of play. Two outs in the seventh. Jose Bautista, the batter, 2-for-4 with a home run and a double. Two outs, nobody on. 19-4 is the score in favor of the White Sox. Outside. 1-0. 10 home runs in one World Series game. I don't think that's ever been done. And I know the past Sox teams, the 2010, 11, and 12 team, have not done that. I think the Sox are the very first team in their history in Major League Baseball to hit 10 home runs in one game. And the score on your screen says it all. And a good, good hold by Batista. Almost went around. He's ahead of the count, 2-0. This Sox team got hot at the right time in Game 6 of the ALCS. It carried over to Game 7 and has definitely carried over to Game 1 of the Fall Classic. 2-1 on Batista. The fourth shot through the Rockies. Popped up in the air. The infield is there. So is Hilton, who will make the catch. And now retire the side. Time to stretch here in the Rocky Mountains. Sox tag on to cover the ball. 19-4, Sox lead.
Who's got something brand new you never had before?
Who's got the best darn burger?
Introduces four new specialty sandwiches.
Chicken is a new filet, white meat through and through. Our chopped beef steak is U.S. choice. The ham and cheese is new. A great fish sandwich, too.
Who's got the best darn burger and a whole lot more?
New specialty sandwiches.
Burger King and Ryan.
I got the call in the middle of the night. My father was in intensive care. I had to be on the next plane to Chicago. I needed more credit on my Citibank Visa.
He immediately called the Citibank 800 number. He told me he needed emergency credit, and he told me why.
She got $600 approved at 3 in the morning. Citibank was there when I needed them, so I could be there when my father needed me.
Not just Visa, Citibank Visa.
Rosario begins the bottom of the seventh, and his club is there. Here at Coors Field, sang the God Bless America and take me out to the ball game, but I don't think their moods were fixed up after they saw the score when reality set in. Strike taken on Rosario, 0-1. A large lead for Cliff Lee, who could be in his final inning of work. And well deserved, I should say. That's deep to right field again. Batista, this time he'll have to run that deep, though. He'll make the catch for out number one. Brian Wilson and Jesse Crane are warming in the Sox bullpen as we speak, so we may see a pitch hitter for Cliff Lee. As we look at pitch, though, who's 2-3. It'll be the 7, 8, and 9 batters. McCann standing in the pitcher spot, so undoubtedly this will be Cliff Lee's final inning. Has been a good one, to say the least. A good outing. Yes, he surrendered 4 runs, but I'll tell you, he has shut down the Colorado's run-scoring offense. No balls, one strike. The pitch. 2-2. 19-4 Sox lead. You're in the bottom of the seventh inning. They're in game one of the 2013 World Series. Best of seven. Sox work their behinds off to get here. A tough series against Texas. A tough series against Toronto. We don't know what kind of series this will be for these two clubs, but at the moment, it's been all Sox in game one. Ground ball is short. This should take care of this one. And it will. Two outs. Josh Willits coming in. He's 0-3 with a flyout back in the fifth inning. Two outs, nobody on, which means the bases are empty. There's a strike on a foul ball. Strike one. We'll see if Cliff Lee will come in the eighth inning or maybe get pitched in for. We'll see what happens. I think after seeing that base hit, made the manager think twice if he still wants him in the game or not. And after that base hit, I think he wanted that. But I guess in the next inning, if there's a couple of runners on base, you definitely have to pitch in for him. No balls, two strikes, and the pitch. Foul ball, strike number two remains, 0-2. He was reaching for that one. And he'll reach for that one, ground ball to short. That'll take care of the Rockies. 1-2-3 goes Colorado, and the seventh, 19-4 Sox. Brian McCann leads off 2-for-3 with a home run and a single. Not a couple innings ago, of course, that home run, a big one. A monster shot in the second deck, second tier. And that's through the shift, and another base hit for McCann. His third of the ballgame, second one against the shift. And the man up first to begin the eighth. So the batter is Giancarlo Stanton, 2-for-4 with a home run and a single. Man's at first. They're in the top of the eighth inning. And that ball is lifted to center field, a base hit. First and second, nobody out here in the eighth. There's Cliff Lee, 1-for-4 with a double back in the seventh inning. And that's going to do it for Cliff Lee as Victor Martinez will come in to pitch hit for Cliff, and he'll get the double play. Wow, what a play by the second baseman. Two outs quickly. He was robbed of a hit. A tremendous play by the second baseman. Tremendous play. So now it's Jed Lawrie. Well, the Sox management has to do the right thing. They have an RBI chance, and unfortunately for Martinez, he grounds a double play, but the Sox still have an RBI chance as Lawrie swings and misses strike one. Oh, 1. Base hit in the right, another run scores, 20-4 New York. Another hit for Jed Lawrie, and it comes here in the eighth inning. Wow. So now here's Robinson Cano, 3-for-5 with two home runs and a single. One of the top, everybody has gotten a hit, including the pitcher. And I didn't get a hit with Martinez, unfortunately. Strike one on a bad swing and a miss. No balls, one strike. And another base hit, this time the right field. Cano is on, and so is Lawrie for Josh Hamilton with two outs. Hamilton 2-for-5 with a home run and a single. And has an RBI chance here. 20-4 is the score. And we are only in the eighth inning. And a drive deep to right, and that's going to fall in and bring in a run. 21-4 is the score. Hamilton safe in second. And the onslaught continues here in game one of the World Series. My goodness. We look at the show motion camera. Look at that contact swing. A beautiful swing right on the point of contact. And now the batter's Adam Dunn, and boy, did Dunn crush one. This was back in the seventh inning. And he got all of this one. extended the lead. Well, things have changed, but they're good for the Sox. They continue to extend their lead. And now second and third occupy two outs with the base open at first for Dunn, who gets hit and the bases will be loaded. And it all comes down to Adrian Gonzalez now with the bases loaded. Adrian has hit a home run, a three-run homer. That's his only hit of the ballgame. Bases loaded, two outs in the top of the eighth, 21-4 is the score. The pitch to Agon is ripped, and a base hit in the right center. One level score. Here comes the second run. The throw home, not in time. 23-4, New York. An RBI, two RBI hit. Brinkin is second in the ballgame, and things really getting out of hand. Here's Jose Bautista. It's a 19-run ball game. Two outs and two on. Here in the eighth, and another drive in the left field, but this time it's caught, and this inning is over, but the Sox have a couple more runs. Here in the eighth, 23-4, Sox lead. We have a double switch. Brian Wilson will come in to pitch for the New York White Sox. And then you see Victor Martinez, who will have a chance to bat in Brian McCann's spot. And Todd Helton's the batter as we begin the bottom of the eighth. So McCann with a good night will get the night off. It is a 19-run ball game here in the eighth inning. Game one of the World Series. Yes, you heard me. Game one of the World Series. Hard to believe this game is being played like that. There's a ground out and one out already here in the eighth. Tomorrow night, game two of the World Series between the Sox and the Rockies. We'll have it for you at 8 o'clock right here on UPN 5. Got a pitch hitter. Tyler Colvin will come in. Hitting in the pitcher's body, sitting at 267 on two homers and 6 runs batted in. One out, nobody on. Two pitches already and still be two out. The first one a ground out, the second one a fly out. Two gone as Stanton makes the catch. Here's Eric Young Jr. now batting on the left side. 3-for-4 with a triple and two singles. Two outs, nobody on, strike taken. The 0-1, fouled away 0-2. Jesse Crane, the only man warming in the bullpen for the Sox, and he'll probably come in the ninth inning, you would think. There will be a pitch hitter for Brian Wilson, no doubt about it. Ground ball to second, and that'll take care of the Rockies. 1-2-3 goes Colorado. We played 8 here in Denver. 23-4 Sox lead. Starting the ninth, and we have a new hitter in for Brian Wilson, Jim Thome. Thome with 2 home runs and 5 runs batted in so far in the postseason. He's batting in Brian Wilson's spot. And we begin the top of the ninth, 23-4 is the score, a 19-run ball game. And right to the shift. One gone. Ricardo Stanton, 3-for-5 tonight, will be back. And a home run and a couple of singles in between. We apologize for some of the glitches we're having with our controller once again. So keep that with us. One out, base is empty. And got a piece of that one, strike one. So undoubtedly so, Jesse Crane will come in the ninth inning and try to shut the door on this one. As the Sox are just 3 outs away from taking a 1-0 series lead from the Colorado Rockies. Another foul ball, strike number two. No balls, two strikes. One out. And the base is empty. Got jammed there on two remains. No balls, two strikes. And the pitch coming. And a ground ball to short. Long throw by Troy. We'll get him. Tremendous play by Troy Tulowitzki. Two gone. Why couldn't he do that in the beginning of the ball game? And now Victor Martinez, who unfortunately grounded into a double play. He struggled in the postseason. His average at 125. We've seen a lot of the bench so far in the postseason. He did okay for the season, but so far in the postseason, he's been dreadful, 125, and eventually, Donovan Ventura had to take him out of the ballgame because it was going to be atrocious, the performance. Two outs, 0-1 on Martinez, and the pitch, and that'll do it for this inning. 1-2-3, go to Sox. It's train time, trying to close out the deal. 23-4, Sox leading game one. Well, Jesse Crane will come into the ninth inning. 23-4 is the score, and all he has to do is just get the final three outs, which should be easy, you would think, with a 19-run lead, but of course, crazy things have happened, especially this season for the Sox, as you folks have seen throughout the game, Cassie, this season across the WON YouTube network, and a tremendous running catch by Stan on the first pitch of the ninth. Retires Fowler, one gone here in the ninth inning.
Okay. What happened? Yeah, no. The food be out of it.
Carlos Gonzalez the batter. With one gone here in the ninth inning, and the pitch on the way. Ooh, he went too far on that one. Strike one.
No? I don't know.
0-1. And a line of what a catch by Adrian. He dropped the ball, though. He dropped the ball. Good stop, good effort by Agon. Boy, he was a frozen rope. So a man at first for Troy Tulowitzki is one for four with a single back in the first inning. Who's the score here tonight? And now definitely what I base it. That ball was hit too hard. Try taking on one. Rain ahead of the batter, 0-1. The infield is in. And that's going to go through the hole. Base hit in the right field. Off the glove of Batista for a moment. First and second, one out. The Rockies trying to stay alive here. Here's Rosario once before with a single back in the fifth inning. One out, two on. Outside, 1-0. The pitch on the way. Fly ball, base hit in the left field. They're going to wave in that run. Here comes the throw. It's cut off. The throw is not in time. Snow is now the batter with first and second occupied and one out and fouled away, strike one. 23-5 is the score, and there's a drive deep left, and that ball is gone. Ventura's beside himself as Colorado is not making things easy for Dusty Crane and the Sox. 23-8 is the score. How hard it is to get the final two outs in a ball game. This sack Jesse Crane, that one was Tomahawk. And no doubter, big day for Pitco, and now here comes Ludwig. There's nobody warming in the Sox bullpen as of late right now. But that could change. 1-0. Away is a ground ball to short. Oh, he's got it. Two gone, and then Sox are one out away. Some ball game. So the final hope is Todd Elson. He takes it his Rockies franchise for a very long time in his final year. In a baseball uniform period, he has spent his entire career with Colorado. And a drive in a high, deep right center field. Stanton is there, and the ball game is over. This one's in the books. Four and run, but he was dynamite on the mound. So we look at the Sox coming out of the field, leaving the field, and we're going to take a look at today's, or shall I say tonight's, Sox baseball bubblegum card play of the game, and it is undoubtedly Jed Laurie with two leadoff home runs, four hits, six at-bats, and three RBIs. Jed Laurie with a career night on a World Series on a big stage. He did it in the season, he did it in the division and championship league series, and he did it in the World Series. Two home runs, a total of a bunch of hits, and a lot of runs batted in. Jed Laurie is tonight's Topps Baseball Bubblegum Card Player of the Game. A look at his stats one more time. Six at-bats, five runs, four hits, two home runs, three runs batted in, an on-base percentage at .233. Well, that'll do it for this ball game. Be sure to join us tomorrow night at 8 for Game 2 of the World Series between the Sox and the Rockies. Sox lead the series 1-0. So until then, yours truly, John Rios, saying open your game to be a game. Final score from Denver. New York beats Colorado 23-8. So long from Denver.